Welcome back, trainers. So Regice now has a new hitbox, the old one to the left and the new one to the right. There's something you might notice right off the bat on the new one is the landscape is lifted up quite significantly. So for the old one, what I would do was curveball, throw to the left and let go right underneath that tree line. That big tree to the left, I would let go right about there and get those excellence. And now for the new one, it's going to be about where the shoulders are for the Regi, or about where the hands are ending there with those spikes. It doesn't seem difficult. I mean, this has always been a pretty simple raid boss to actually hit excellence on and catch for me too, which we'll go over my catch rate after this and take a look at my Regis. But now we're going to look at some live catches comparison so you can see in action exactly what is going on here if you haven't done any yet. So, and I've also noticed with the new catch screen for Regi that it does seem a little bit closer, almost as if they were trying to make the circle in the same spot. Technically, if you threw the way you did before, you would almost hit an excellent, but I don't really feel like that's the case. When it was on the tip of its head where you had to make the circle small right on the top there, right at the point, I feel like you had to toss it up just a little bit higher. On this one, it's kind of more of like a spin low throw and straight up. It's not difficult at all. So for the new catch screen, I'm gonna be letting go of my curveball right around where its shoulders are and where the fingertips on the Regi end, in between the shoulders and the hands. So where the arms are, that's where I'm gonna let go of my curve and just gonna bam, right into the middle, right into the stomach area. It's not gonna be hard. You're gonna give it a shot. You're gonna see, okay, this is not so difficult. Now, the older landscape is farther down. It's quite significant change, can't you see? It almost looks like my alignment for my video is off, but no, that's not the case. They just changed it that much. Now for the new catch screen to the right, it may seem like I'm throwing it higher than the arm length is there, but that's just me, you know, spinning it, flinging it up, it goes up. I am literally letting go right about where the hands are. So give it a shot, see what you can do. You can hit excellent after excellent after excellent on this thing. As long as you wait for it to attack, it's not difficult. Same with the old Regi, it was fairly simple. And for the trainers that do not curveball, I recommend you let go right about where the eyes start on the Regi and you should be good. Just make sure it attacks first and then fling it up. But I do highly recommend that you start to try to curveball because that's just going to increase your odds of catching. If you haven't practiced by now, or if you're new and you still haven't learned how to curve throw, just go out there, catch a bunch of Pokemon, you know, curve throw it up, see what you can do. The bigger the hit circle, the easier it's gonna be for you to get those excellent. So just depending on the Pokemon you're throwing at. So I hope you enjoyed that comparison side by side actual video here. I'm happy I saved the clips. I'm just gonna do some compilation of it. I don't know exactly what, but this is actually the one here as well to the right where I'm hitting in the circle two times. And then the second I go outside of the ring, I catch it. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. One shake, two and three. So it's pretty funny. This game is so random. Just goes to show how random this game is. You can hit excellent, 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 great, 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 golden Raz all the way. And the second you hit outside that circle, bingo, you're gonna catch it. Pretty funny. And I also keep catching high IV ones. And as a matter of fact, let's go ahead and hop into Pokemon Go and take a look at all that now, shall we? Okay, so before we take a look at my Regis and my catch rate for them, let's go ahead and look at my researches here. I'm going to save it for Snorlax. I know some people may think, well, why don't you just go for Articuno? It's just a Snorlax. It is, but you know, I want to have the video ready. So another question I get a lot is, how do I have four researches here? I don't want to touch them because I don't want to claim it by accident, but the very top one is not an actual research thing. Well, it is, but it's a Pokemon stacked up. So say I claim one of the bottom Pokemons that has a question mark and then the grass, and then I back out, it'll get stacked up and it just shows it one right there, the very first one. And as I go down, it'll have more. If you can see all of them and if I can scroll up, there would be over 100 in there waiting. I'm saving them for a rainy day, maybe when I'm like traveling or something, stuck somewhere where there's no Pokemon, I might catch him, turn on a star piece. But that is that question answered there. There is not four researches here. There's only three, and those are the Pokemon waiting to be claimed. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at my catch rate for this thing. As far as I know, only one has ran on me. Pretty fantastic. I remember the one that ran, it was weird because I was hitting excellence with golden curve every single time. And I was thinking to myself, wow, this thing actually can run. So that was pretty funny. But hey, 14 out of 13 or 13 out of 14 is not bad at all. So I'll take it. And not only that, not only do I have a good catch rate, I have a lot of good Regis. Like, I don't understand. It's like maybe enticing me to power it up. I don't think that's the case. I'm just messing around. So my best one is going to be 1752, which is a 95%. Let me see here. Attack. Wow. Yeah, it's 95-98%. It's pretty darn good. Pretty happy about that. Then we have a 93. I do believe this one is the, hold on, let's see here. Defense. Oh no, okay. So this other one is the one I would power up, because we have HP and attack are both maxed out. So I would definitely go for this one with the lower defense if I was ever to even think about powering it up, which I don't think I want to. So I'm looking good. Just missed one. Unfortunately, it's not something I want to dump my rare candies into at the moment. Plus, I have a few more power-ups down the road. Little surprises for you guys. So with that said, I'd like to say thank you for watching, and I'll be catching you all next time. Take care.